My name is Adwoa Biotech, and today we're talking about serial dilutions for creating standard curves, dose responses, calibration curves for calibrating equipment. So serial dilutions involve you diluting a substance, such as protein, a compound, or drug, in a stepwise manner. So what you end up with is even or constant dilutions from one point or one concentration to the next. You need to use serial dilutions whenever you need to determine the concentration of a protein or drug or nucleic acid in an unknown sample by comparing it to known concentrations that you use to create what is called a standard curve. Standard curves, as you may know, are created by checking the signal. The signal can be absorbance, fluorescence, or luminescence that is generated from known concentrations of either your protein, nucleic acid, or drug of interest in order to work out comparatively the concentration of a sample that you've just maybe extracted from a cell or received from a patient sample. Serial dilutions are also used when you need to determine the concentration of a compound or drug that is required to reduce a biological activity or interaction by 50%, what is referred to as inhibitory concentration 50 or IC50, through the creation of a dose response curve. Again, you may use serial dilutions when you need to create standards for calibrating equipment or instruments to check that the measurements being obtained from the equipment or instrument is appropriate. So how do you do it? You generally want at least 5 concentrations to compare your sample to. If you just picked one concentration, what would be the problem with that? Clearly, if your concentration in your sample is really high and the concentration you happen to pick was low, then you're not going to be able to make any comparisons. If you only pick 2 concentrations and then the sample you have, it's not close to either of those 2 concentrations, once again, you can't really infer what the concentration or estimate what the concentration in your unknown sample is. So ideally, at least 5 concentration points, 5 or more, is what's recommended. So then you decide the dilution series you want to use. You want to do a 1:2, a 1:3, a 1:5, a 1:10. And once you've decided it, you just need to calculate what you want to start off with and then how many points you want. So you want to do it for 5. It's the minimum, like we said, or, 10 points or 20 points or, however many. And you just do it stepwise at the same dilution between each point. So what are the advantages of doing your dilutions this way? The first one is that it saves time. You only go into your stock protein, nucleic acid, compound, or drug once rather than multiple times for each of the 5 or more dilutions that you want to do. Second, which is the most important, you have constant dilution, as we said, at each step. And the importance of that is that at each doing the constant dilution at each step allows concentration curves that are on a logarithmic scale. What is a logarithmic scale? If you want me to explain that, I can do that in a further video. So just let me know in the comments. Thirdly, error minimization. So preparing 5 different volumes for a standard curve or a dose response is considered to have potentially compound the errors that you have from each pipetting. So it's considered that if you just take the one volume, pipette the one volume, and then serially dilute it, you minimize the errors that are associated with you pipetting multiple times. So some terminology that will be used around this sort of data that I just wanted to hit you up on, clarify, because people will be using it around you, is fold change or difference. So the fold change refers to the difference in a signal and therefore concentration between the measured samples. For example, if this signal and therefore the concentration of one patient or treatment group is twice that of another, it is referred to as a twofold change. You will also hear logarithmic, you may also hear logarithmic dilution. This refers to a tenfold serial dilution, such as, you know, if your top concentration is 10 micromolar, then the next will be one, the next will be, following that will be 0.1, then 0.01, then 0.001 if you're doing 5 points. So because it's tenfold, it's referred to as a logarithmic dilution or log dilution. And you may also hear a half log dilution, which is 3.16 fold serial dilution, or even a quarter log dilution, which is a 1.78 fold dilution. Another terminology, orders of magnitude. So here's an explanation that I liked from Wikipedia. So if we were to compare the surface of an orange to that of the surface of Earth, I would say the Earth is many, many orders of magnitude larger than an orange. So orders of magnitude then is an approximation of differences, and it's uniquely used when doing scientific notations. So if the difference is greater than 100, it is two orders of magnitude. If the difference is just is greater than 10, it is one order of magnitude larger. If it's three orders of magnitude, then what do you reckon? It's 1,000 times larger. So differences that are on the same order of magnitude are less than tenfold. So that's it for this video, just getting the terminologies and background to it. And then in the next video, we can look at analyzing data from standard curves and dose responses. Thank you for watching. All the best with creating your standard curves or dose response experiments.